Yo, 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 what up, everybody? Mic check, mic check, mic check, checking everything else. You can hear me out there? This is the day that the Lord has made, baby. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. 2024 Chicago High School Baseball Classic. It's in full effect. We had technical difficulties for the first game. We apologize about that. But we laughing up and we rocking and rolling for the second game, baby. First game week was between Lane Tech versus Homewood Flossmoore pulled out a thriller, winning that game. MVP of that game was Torrey Chaney, a young man who I've known for quite some time. The kid flashed the leather like it was no other today, man. So shouts out to Torrey and the Chaney family. Congratulations to you guys on that award. And Coach Marcus, man, you know, he did an outstanding job, you know, playing in the tough division that he's playing in and playing one of the top teams out in CPS. You know, it was huge. So shout out to Coach Marcus. Hope we can get him up here in the booth and get an interview with him, which would be awesome. So that's what we're going to hope for. We have a couple special guests joining us this game. We have several pro players here. Legendary catcher, Charles Johnson, Cal Stonesworth, Luis Alcia. Like we have some guys. Shout out to Rise of Greatness. Shout out to Rise of Greatness for helping Black Baseball Media put this thing together, man. And it is a beautiful day out here, and we're very blessed. We have the mayor that y'all seeing out here of the greatest city in the whole wide world, city of Chicago. Y'all know how we do it. If you don't know who this voice is, it's the voice of Black Baseball Media. Your boy, Booker T on the mic. So sit back and let's get ready, y'all. Second game. Kenwood versus Ogden. New kids on the block. They here. They said they come from up north. Humble Park area there. All the way to the south side. They said they finna take it. On the bump for Kenwood, we have the ticket, as he's called. Kabari Thunderbird. Left-hander. Logan Commit, MLB prospect. On the mound for the Kenwood Broncos. He was MVP last year, looking to do the same thing this year. So hopefully we can go ahead and get them guys going now. For the Ogden Owls, I believe we have Sammy Castillo, I believe, on the mound. I'll double check that in a second while I put up these rosters. As y'all hear in the background, we is bumping. Yes, Sammy Castillo's on the mound for the Ogden Owls. Big guy. Real tough, real aggressive on the mound. Should be a good dandy today, fellas. Watching these two fellas go at it. Once again, we rocking and rolling. Stay tuned. We'll be back at the start of the game. Kenwood versus Ogden. Love them to have a 2:30 start time. So we'll be back then. Peace. Ryan. Hey. We back, y'all. Beautiful day in the city of Chicago, 69 degrees. About 4 minutes to game time, I believe. Give you a little rundown of the rosters for both teams. First, the new kids on the block, the Ogden International Cows.
Now, one question, what's your zodiac sign?
Roster goes as follows.
Gemini.
Number one, Gemini. Carlos Garcia. Number two,
we about to get started, y'all.
Oso Vega.
Starting here in Chicago.
Three, Jacob Cordero. Five, it's Juju Castillo. Seven, Sammy Catalillo. Number eight, Diego. Number 11, Malachi Gonzalez. Number 13, last name is LeBron. That's pretty dope. Number 19 is Johnny Clay. Number 21 is John Carlos. Number 23 is Luis. And number 24 is Vincent. The head coach is William Poole. Associate head coaches goes as follows: Anthony Mazzano, Corey Hearn, Todd Tobar, Guillermo Guzman. We have the Kenwood Academy, Broncos, CBS Champs, Zero, Jonathan Patterson Jr., number two, Demarion Butler, number four, Kavari Thunderbird, number five is Delvin Williams, number six, Daniel Luster. Seven is Jimmy Dowles. Number nine is Nick Waller. Number 16 is Kamari Thomas. Number 21 is Savion Flowers. 25 is Brandon Stinson. We got number 27 is Quincy Matthews. Number 32 is Antonio Porterville Jr. Number 33 is Evan Stinson. Number 42, we have Destin Edwards. And rounding out, it's number 44, Philip Pigpen. Head coach is David Reed. Associate head coach goes as follows: Carnell Blackman, Jill Somerset, and Max Huckabee. That rounds out the roster for both teams. I know I kind of chopped up some names. I should have did my research. But, you know, that's how it is sometimes. But it's a beautiful, gorgeous day out here. We have the media out here, as you guys can see right there, interviewing Coach David right now. Coach Ernest, his envision, what he wanted to do and set out and bring recognition back to the city of Chicago as being not just a great city for basketball, but also one of the greatest and toughest cities for the game of baseball as well. So shouts out to you, Coach. Your vision came true. And you had a lot of people believing in you and back in this dream, man. And this man is beautiful. It's totally, totally beautiful. This is awesome, man. People say the city can't come together and do great things. This is what it's about right here. This is awesome. This is truly awesome. Joining me in the booth, y'all. Four cup winners right now. Probably half his game. We have a legend that played at Simeon Career Academy, aka the Machine, as they call it. This man went there, pitched, went on to Alcorn State University, was a teacher, and Lord bless him to get his dream job, going back and coming back and giving what he loves to do, and that's being one of the head directors of one of the best travel programs in the nation. People have tried to copy and duplicate it, but it's none like it. If you guys know what I'm talking about the associate assistant head coach at Simeon Career Academy, Troy Williams, everybody. Troy, how you feeling, man?
It's all good, man. How you doing, brother?
Man, that was a great intro, man.
Hey, man, I tried. I watched drink you.
Man, what did I do to deserve that?
Hey, man, you're doing the thing, man. man. You've been blessing the youth, man. So we want to give you flowers.
I appreciate it, man. This is we got a beautiful day for some baseball too.
Yeah, man. Look at this, man. 69 degrees, not a cloud in sight.
Not a cloud in the sky. I'm excited to see this matchup. I think what I'm most excited to see is two dogs go at it, two horses go at it, man. You got Jabari Thunderbird on one side, and you got Sammy Castillo on the other, man. Two guys that I've had the chance to watch up close and personal, and got a chance to kind of see them do their thing. So I'm excited for a good pitching duel, to be honest.
Man, you got it, man. This is going to be pretty awesome. You have to coach against the Kenwood Broncos, man, and you know, you guys first match up with them. How was the first matchup with you guys?
Dog fight, man. So Kenwood's an interesting group because I've been around those guys. I've coached most of the guys on that team, and I will say I had cheat code from a scouting report perspective, man. He had a young sophomore on the mound, Jeremiah, and he went out and he mixed it up really well for 5 minutes. And he had him off balance, and you know, honestly, we were just a few hits away. We made a couple mental mistakes and kind of let our emotions take over the game, but this Kenwood group is tough.
Yeah, they are tough, man. I mean, you talking about a group that has about four Division I commits on the team. You have an MLB prospect that's going to take the bump today. If you never watched Kabari Thunderbird before, you know,
sit back and watch.
You know, I might be a little biased because that is my family. So, you know, if you hear me get a little excited when he, you know, throwing some of that, you know,
yeah, nah,
apologize. Please apologize. You know, please accept my apology right now.
But nah, this Kenwood group is, over the years, they have matured and, you know, they're city champions, so they're proven, you know. And one thing that we got to make sure, that we continue to watch is just they got to hit. They have to have some timely hits, you know.
Yeah, I think, you know, they started off, you know, on a struggle bus just a little bit this year, but I believe that the talent that they have, you know, will prevail at the end. You know, I believe they're too good. And I believe, you know, sometimes you have to go through a little bit of adversity and a little bit of, a little bit of struggle to see, you know, to test the will of and the heart of the team. So, you know, this right here, you know, can be, you know, can catapult them into springboard them into a long winning streak, you know, if they get their match right, I believe. And I believe having Dave Reed at the head coaching position, you know, he knows one way and one way only, and that's to go hard. So I believe that, you know, him being his first time as a first-year head coach himself, this is going to be this is pretty good for him to, you know, get his feet wet.
Yeah, nah, David is going to come out and he's going to be super aggressive. And one thing you know about him, he's going to be very aggressive on the bases. He's going to apply pressure. He's going to mix it up. And the guys got to execute, man. It's a hell of a group, and I think that the more they continue to gel together, like they start, like you said, they started out a little rough, but they're going to continue to be better and better and better. You know what I mean? In CPS baseball, as we know, everybody got a chance.
Man, they do.
It's like the AL Central in baseball.
Hey, all you got to do is
my White Sox, you can win. You win 80 games, you can make the playoffs.
Well, you know what? I mean, we ain't going to talk
about
this.
We ain't winning 80 games.
We ain't winning 80 games. I think the over-under for us this year might be 40. That's no disrespect, man. But
I'm going to stay out of that conversation.
Yeah, I can do a little bit talking. But I love it. I'm a diehard White Sox fan. Everybody know that to the death. But, you know, I'm hoping we can turn those things around on a major league platform as well, too. But the Ogden Owls, man, what do you know about them, Coach Troy?
Scrappy, man. I got a chance to watch them against St. Rita. And they just, they don't quit. They don't quit, man. One thing I know, the guy that's starting for him today, Sammy Castillo, Sammy is going to mix it up. He's going to compete. He's tough as they come. They got a couple guys. Malachi over there, he's the center fielder, man. He's going to get after it. And Poole is a good baseball mind, their head coach. You know, him, Corey Hearn, those dudes, you know, they're going to make sure they prepare their guys for the situation. They got a couple young freshmen that are on this group. And I think that it's going to be a heavyweight matchup today. Heavyweight matchup.
Well, you know, we in it, man. We in it for a good start. The starting lineups have been announced. Ross has been there. Maiden. We got Mr. Mike Maiden on the first pitch.
Michael Maiden, man, dude is a legend, man. Started the, founded the program at Olive Harvey. You know, was one of the old baseball minds around, you know, the 80s and the 90s, man. Put a lot of kids on, so a lot of respect for that man.
That man has seen some of the greats, man. You talking about some of the greats here in Chicago. He's seen the Lou Carriers and Marvin Freemans. He's seen the Kirby Puckets.
Yeah.
You know.
He's seen them all.
Seen them all, man. So, you know, you got a guy like this.
Come on, Mike, throw a strike.
Let's see if he can throw a strike, though. Come on, coach.
All right, coach.
All right, man. He said he just came off Tommy John.
Coach K, hey. That's all right, man.
This is pretty dope. This is pretty dope, man. This is what it's about.
I feel like, man, we couldn't ask for a better day.
Man, Troy, you couldn't. Like, last year was a little bit chilly. You know what I'm saying? That night, man, for, you know, for us to go from this the third year, and we got three games, man. Three games. To see what it started at, Troy. You know, you was part of the conversation as well, too. And to see where it's at now, man, I mean, it just make you feel proud that, you know, Earn, you know, he's seen this vision, and, man, he pushed through it.
I tell him all the time, man, I'm proud of him. And everybody, that whole team, man, Jamar Warren, you know, they have a Alex. They got a group that is determined. They're focused. They're laser focused.
Yeah.
You know, and they're just – they doing what they got to do, man, to make sure that our kids and our communities are being exposed to the game at a high level. You know, to be able to play on this field, it's a beautiful field. And, you know, shouts out to Ozinga and these guys here, because there's a lot of people that wouldn't give us the opportunity to play on these types of fields,
man,
when we were coming up.
No, man, they wouldn't, man. And to see that, but like Coach Arnold said, man, we're not going to just ask for, we want to sit at the table. And if not, we'll just build our own. And right now, we're building our own table here at Black Baseball Media. And it's a beautiful thing, man. So sit back, strap it down, and we're going to have the first pitch, man. Not the first pitch. Here we are.
We got the first pitch.
There we go.
Yeah, I'm excited to see Kavari, man. I haven't seen him pitch in a while, so this is
feeling good. Good. One on one's a count. Kavari got the long sleeves on today.
He like me, man. When I was when I was pitching, man, it didn't matter if it was 90 or 60. I was wearing long sleeves.
You was wearing long sleeves.
I just always felt more comfortable in the long sleeve. Loose long, though. Loose long.
You look at his body, man. Kavari, like, he's been getting stronger, man. You know, that's been one of the things on him. He's going to get, you know, he's long and lean. But you want to put on that good muscle mass, too, for the next level.
Yeah.
One ball, two strikes to count. See what we got here. On the swing!
Like a changeup right there.
Yeah.
He's got a developing one, man. Over the years, I watched him. I remember when he couldn't even grip the change, and now he's throwing it as his out pitch.
That's called dedication. It's odd and out, man. I believe if they come out and they can't be scared. They got to come out here and just battle. And I believe, like you said, they're a scrappy group. And them coming from the Humble Park area, man. You know what I'm saying? They're going to be tough. They're going to be tough and scrappy. So I'm excited, man, like you said.
They don't quit, man. I said they played us tough. We ended up tying with them.
Man.
You know, and I was telling, you know, Coach Smoke and those guys, I'm like, look, you know, this group is going to be super tough. And that they were, you know, tough out.
Kavari's doing what he had to do. Getting that first pitch for a strike, you know, it was huge. I think the Ogden Owls need to attack that pitch. You know, if it's gonna be first pitch fastball, go at it.
I don't know if they can catch up.
Yeah.
Nah, they Kavaris looks like he locked in. You know, there's a few kids, and you and I know both. There's a few kids that you can look at and you just see the
it factor,
the look in their eyes, and yep. You know when they locked in.
Got that change up a little bit too tight right there.
Yeah, he locked in today.
We got the mail here, Troy. That was pretty dope, wasn't it, man?
Yeah, man. Brandon Johnson, man.
Shout out to him, man.
Came through for a minute, showed him some love.
Yeah.
I coached his son. I coached Owen.
Yeah, I coached Owen at the gym, too.
Back at 12 and 13. Yeah, so.
I had him at gym. There you go. Red attack. Okay, coach, I see you down there.
Good little ball player. Even better soccer player, though.
For real?
Yeah, Owen plays soccer, man. He's very good at soccer from what I hear, so.
That's dope, man.
Yeah.
That's pretty dope.
Yeah, JB behind the plate. JB a good guy, man. Shout out to all the umpires.
Yeah, man.
It's a hard job, man. I think they get a bad rep. You know,
Some of them sometimes, man, they let their ego get in play, man.
For sure.
We're gonna keep it a beat.
It's all of us, though.
Yeah, it is. Kavari. Full count now, right?
Yeah, Brandon Stinson back there. He's, Brandon Stinson back there, controlling the other half of the battery. Good catcher, man, good guy.
Here we go, full count. Pitch. There you go. What attack? Ah! Pop up. Big league, as they say. In the sun. Oh, that's why you got to run it out. That might come back and bite him. That's an error.
Yeah, I see what happened, man. Phil thought he was under that one. I think the sun just got him.
Yep. Here we go. This is the big fella, right? This old Sammy?
Nah, that's not Sammy.
Okay. Go. Three hit. What we got? That's how you come back at the error, man. You come back,
man. You
throw the first big strike, you know.
What happens is, man, what a lot of guys get hung up on is the fact that, you know, guys gonna make errors.
Mm-hmm.
It happens, you know.
Yeah.
And you gotta be, as a pitcher, you gotta make sure that you're mentally capable of coming back from it.
Honestly, was it? Did he go? He didn't go. He held up. All right. Because it's going to take up that right corner right there.
Yeah.
So what I said, we're going to have a little fancy, but Kavari has one of the best pickoff moves in the state. Big hat.
Yeah, if he goes at him, you know, he Kavari stays true to his guns. He's gonna compete and throw a lot of fastballs, and he'll mix it up. I think they got a good chance, man.
I think Ogden, Keenan Victor's playing a little small ball today too, man.
Yeah,
play a little small ball. Don't let your ego get to you.
Two outs.
You know, that's a huge striker right
there. Blew a bomb right there,
man.
You can't.
There it is.
You can't ask for nothing better than that.
We got two outs. Number 34 comes up to play.
Stepping into the batter's box for Ogden, number 34, Peyton.
Kavari going to come set. And the pitch.
That boy. It's a good pitch right there.
That's right.
Straight.
There we go. Ogden has to be aggressive. Come set, this pitch. Ball high. Got a 1-1 count.
Here, Coach Carnell Blackman down there telling him, stay smooth, flatten it out a little bit. Kavari, he'll get erratic sometimes, but that's the nature of the pitcher, man.
Yeah.
There it is.
There you go. Hey, that's how you compete right there. One thing Ogden is showing, man, they're showing that they are not scared. And I believe that's the key. You know, you cannot come up here like you're scared. You got to come attack a pitcher like Avari and say, hey, man, we're going to go at you. And they doing it right now. You know, they coming out, they hacking. You know, I like to strike out swinging. You know, I don't like people striking out looking.
Yeah, so, nah.
If you're going down swinging, hey, you give yourself a chance. You got a 50-50 chance, as they say.
Yeah.
You don't swing, guess what? You ain't got one chance.
You don't have a chance. You don't have a chance, so.
Come set. In the pitch. Left that a little high. Probably changing eye level, as they say.
Losing some baseballs out here.
I know, man. And we got specially made baseballs this year, too, man. We got the logo.
Shout out to Rollins.
Yes, sir.
Shout out to Rollins on the baseballs, man.
Yeah, man. Definitely. Right, come set.
Oh.
Attacking them in the inside. Got to get them hips through the zone quick. Mm. 69 degrees on a Saturday afternoon in the city of Chicago.
Can't beat it, man.
This is what high school baseball is about. 2-2-2-2. See what we gonna do. What are we doing? He's gone. Oh, he dropped on a transfer. Whoa, I will appeal that. Could have been on a transfer. Alrighty.
Be safe.
Kid was not. His not. I thought he tagged. I thought it was on the transfer.
Yeah, no, he's safe. He's safe. That's a good call by JB. Maybe I told you that one right.
Coach Dave will go ahead and argue.
You gotta do that.
Yeah, definitely. I believe he didn't know the count, and I believe that's why he walked like that.
The kid thought it was ball four.
Yeah, you know, you have to, and kids out there, if you're listening, you're watching. You know, when you come back and you watch this, you have to stay in the game. You know, because that could have cost you a run. You know, cost you an out in a pretty tight game, you got a kid like Avari throwing. You know, we can't make mistakes. Yeah. Can't make mistakes at all. But luckily,
you know. So you got a full count? You got a full count here?
Yep. Here we go, we got a full count, 3-2. As they say, we got a base hit. Could it score a run? We got the first hit of the game.
We got two outs.
First and third, two outs.
Now back for Ogden, number 20, Nick Espada.
To get to Kavar, you want to rattle him, can't be up there scared. I believe Ogden House is showing a great deal. Showing a great deal and great fortitude to come out here and say, hey, you know what, we know who you are, we're going to come at you. You know, that shout out to the coaches, instilling that toughness in them. Uh-oh, foul pitch. We have the first score of the game. The first run to Ogden Owls. One hit, one run, one error. That pop fly cost him. You have to take advantage of every opportunity that you have. The pitch. All right, three balls, no strikes, two outs. Gotta settle down right here. Live here in Ozunga Field.
pitch.
So they come back. 3-1. Crowd is filling in, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, yeah.
The Ogden Owls have shown that, look, hey, we're going to come out. We're going to compete. We're going to do this. Number seven. Wait. Two outs, two men on. Pitch. On a swing. I believe if Ogden scratch another run right here, I believe that'd be huge to their confidence and giving Sammy and giving him confidence to go on that mound and say, you know what, you need to shut him down. I think they can scratch another run right here that'll rattle the Broncos. It ain't going. Kavari not even looking at him. He said, hey, I'm going after him. It's the one I want. Sometimes pitchers, they do that because they're so pumped up to get to the next person. You got an 0-2 count. Two men on, two outs. Kavari looks in, comes set. And the pitch. On a swing! Huge, big strikeout. Top of the first inning. Ogden Owls came over one hit, one run, one error by Kenwood Broncos. As we went to the bottom of the first. Ogden Owls. Uno. Broncos coming up. Right back. We're back, ladies and gentlemen. Show them, bud. Michigan State commit.
Ari Thomas, man.
This kid's a stud.
Yeah, he can play some baseball.
Yes, he can. Speed, athleticism. Sure.
He can do it all, man. Yep. He's somebody I've enjoyed watching over there.
Years. Ooh. Ooh, that hurt.
Yeah, that was hurt, man.
Yeah, man. I walked that one off.
Those are the ones that had you down for a couple games.
Man. Way to defend your position. Way to defend your position. Mr. Butler's up. Ball one. So what do you think about this Sammy kid, man? He's coming out. He's showing he don't care about the name on the front of the chest.
Nah, Sammy's Sammy gonna compete, man. He's a competitor. Comes from a baseball family. His older brother Francois was a stud.
Mm-hmm.
You know. And his other brother played at Olive Harvey. He pitched as well. So he comes from baseball. He comes from baseball stock, you know?
Hit batter. Take first base. Get on anyone you can, man. Three-hole hitter right here. This is Jimmy Downs.
Light tower power right here. reminds me of your son, just on the right side. Don't miss a lot of fastballs. And can get the ball in the gap with ease.
Sammy got to settle down. It's four balls in a row. It's five. Settle down. There you go.
That boy. That's a good take right there.
Yep.
Probably make him take two or three more times.
Mm-hmm.
Knowing Coach Reed, you know.
Hey, take it till you get us right.
Uh-huh. A little anxious right there.
Yeah. Two balls on strike from the bottom. Going. Hit and run was on. Way to protect the runner. Oh, nobody got no hands over there. Come on.
Everybody ducking.
You got 2-2 on the battle. Hit 70 degrees, Mark. Troy, look at that.
It's nice, man.
You know?
Very nice out here.
And I have to get in here, man.
Yo, base hit. Here we go. Can he score? He's going to make it. Is Jimmy going to get there? We might have an inside the park home run. He got to sit him. You got to sit him just for the heck of it. This is what the classic do. This is what we do. The throw at the plate. Oh, he got him. He got him. What an exciting play, ladies and gentlemen.
Wow. That's a good relay right there.
You got to. I'm not mad at that, Coach Dave.
Not mad
at it. And it took that kid, lights out. He could have gave up on the play, but he busted his butt to center field to get that ball in, Troy.
Nah, that was a way to get that ball in. That ball was smoked.
Smoked?
Get the ball in. The relay was perfect. He couldn't have drew it up any better.
Couldn't have.
I don't believe it. Don't grab it. I told you I got you.
All right, we got coming to the plate. Yeah, it's the guru. I just took over. I had to get next to the White Sox ace, Troy Williams.
What's up, man?
Man, I thank you guys so much for your sponsorship. Make sure y'all go follow White Sox Charities right now, White Sox Charities. We got coming to the plate, Saving Our Flowers, the Eastern Kentucky University recruit.
Light Tower Power right here.
Foul ball.
Saving Our, if you throw him a fastball, you may not be able to get it by him.
Oh, yeah.
How you feeling, man? It's a good event, man. You couldn't have drawn it up better, man. The weather is perfect today.
Man, God is good.
Why are they clapping?
Call ball.
Old Sammy Castillo, huh? Clear. 3-1.
Right. And here's the pitch.
It's a good take. I don't mind that in that count, in that situation. Guru, what you looking for right here?
You gotta see it on one pitch right here, baby. Ah, big swing and a miss. That's a great pitch by Sammy Castillo. He's fired up out there. At the end of one, Ogden Owls 1, Kenwood Broncos 1. So we're back, ladies and gentlemen. We have the extreme pleasure of having the guru and Mr. Williams in the booth with me for a couple innings. You know, came over here to keep your boy company. Absolutely, man. Look at the voice of BBM, Troy, the mayor of Chicago baseball.
Hello.
Yeah. And the guru, you can't beat this.
This is what it's about right here, ladies and gentlemen.
Beautiful day in Chicago. We right here, just a little bit south of Chicago. We in Crestwood.
Hello, number three, Chick, whatever.
See if Kavari settled down his inning. There you go.
First pitch strike.
The ticket. What do y'all expect to see from the ticket this inning?
I think his RPM's a little bit down, drilling's out. He can settle in and make his pitches. That's what I got.
Yeah, absolutely. On a pitch. Ball, huh?
once the emotions settle in after the first inning, I think everybody comes back to reality.
Now it's time to play baseball.
Yeah.
You know, Ogden came out with that, they came out with the tension. Hey, we ain't scared of you. I'm swinging.
I think he's going to come around after he's got a fastball. I don't think he's going to play around with a breaking pitch.
If I know Coach Carnell Blackman, it's definitely fastball away.
Let's see.
Ooh. Just missed. Just missed.
Last year, Kenwood played in this. Kawhi was MVP. For the classic.
You know he's going for it again.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
There it is.
Swing and a miss.
There it is.
I think we need to trademark there it is, Coach Booker.
We might have to. Put that on the shirt. That's the call now, baby. Oh, yeah.
Shout out to the sponsor, Country Financial, Doran Stewart. Thank you for your sponsorship.
Cuzzo. That's my cousin, man.
Oh, Doran Stewart. It's your family. Your family.
That's family right there, man.
Shout out to all the sponsors, man. We couldn't do this without you guys. On the pitch, ball high.
It's a little high.
Coachy, how you feel, man? You look around, you see this, man. I mean, you know, take it for your emotions, man. All the hard work and all the tears that night, man, that people don't see. Well, listen.
Hey, this is what we want. That's only gonna grow.
So don't get bigger. And if you guys don't know, there is another game after this. The Battle of Vince is. And they're going to be out the night for that one. I tell you that much, Joe. I tell you that much.
Morgan Park has an RV behind left field.
And we're going to show y'all, too. We're going to zoom in. We're going to pan over to it. The pitch. Here we go.
It's going to come right. He's going to come right after Ogden Owls right now.
Yeah, he has to.
Y'all said the Battle of Vince is. And,
oh, here we go.
I know where this one is.
Are they located on Vincent's Troy?
I think they're on a street called Pryor.
You on Pryor?
Pryor Street. Okay. 1744 West Pryor, to be exact.
Okay.
So I'm Googling the address, it's correct.
So it's only one official school on Vincent's?
It's really only one school on Vincent's, man. And this is my bias moment in the booth where I gotta let everybody know that.
It's okay. It's
okay. Okay.
There's only one school on Vincent's. Unfortunately, those other guys, they on the side street.
Kawhi comes set. On a swing. There it is.
Swing and a miss, the ticket. Got two away here.
Coach Troy, let's talk about White Sox charity, man. You played in the ACE program, and now that you know you're leading the program, man. When you look at some of the guys that's under your development, how does it make you feel? And knowing that you're, you know, giving back not only your time but your love as well too.
Yeah, it's surreal, man. It's a surreal feeling. Every day I wake up, I get a chance to go in and do something that I love. So, and that's providing resources and
there's a hit up the middle. Did it play Kamara? Oh, you got to lay off for that one, I believe.
Yeah, and that's just providing resources and opportunities for young people around the city. The one thing that I will say, like, our big league team may not be doing well, but the one thing we are doing better at everybody else across the league is getting in the community and doing work.
Say it for the people in the back, Coach.
That's our Jersey program that we do with inner city youth baseball. That's our White Sox ACE program. This is our signature program in the department. So we're doing it the right way. We're going to keep doing it. We ain't going nowhere.
How many over the years, man? I mean, just give, you know, the countless people who came through ACE and, you know, and the kid and the countless draft picks, the countless college commits, the countless coaches who come back to coach for ACE, and just overall guys in the community that's also might be coaching at another level. That ball got away.
Oh, Brandon got to work a little harder to get that
one.
Yeah. Yeah, it's, I mean, you talk about 29 guys drafted in 18 years. You look at over 300 guys who receive scholarships.
currently 98 players playing on college rosters. Like, it's we do it the right way. We don't fly guys in. We don't do guest players. We don't do we don't do that. So we everybody's homegrown, and you know, the White Sox invest an immense amount of money into these guys, and all we do is ask for a commitment. We ask for loyalty. We ask for people to, you know, commit to us. I mean, Book, you know, your son came through the program from when he was a youngin', man.
Yeah, my son came in. I coached for Ace for quite some time. And you got to chop off the middle. Kamari plays his position, the throw. First. All right.
That's a good stretch. Hold on.
Where's it?
Jamar.
And we're back. Bottom of the second. Sammy Castillo back on the bump.
Foul ball.
Come on, Coach Dave. You gotta have that one down there. Jeez.
Coach Dave was catching, so.
Dave don't play no defense.
They doing you dirty, Dave.
He was a hitter.
That he can do.
Coach David Reed used to tear the SEC up. LSU, Mississippi State. I remember going to those midweek games, and I was a young freshman watching. He was tearing the SEC up.
Ball hat. Someone won on count.
Overall good player, and he was our captain, man. He was our leader.
Good crowd out here today, man.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Starting to fill up a little bit.
And it's going to get crazy later.
Yeah.
I'll tell you
that much.
Yeah, we can see.
When the Wolverines show up.
Yeah, we know when y'all come out, it's going to be crazy.
I think they're all meeting up on 83rd and got a police escort.
And marching down. Oh, hi.
Yeah. Shout out to Mayor Brandon Johnson.
The mayor is here.
He
we talking about
the building.
Him. Hopefully we can sneak him up and get an interview, guys. I think that'd be pretty awesome.
Hey, share this live if y'all want to have Mayor Brandon Johnson on. I need 100 people to watch right now.
That's a walk. Sammy has to attack his own, man. One thing he cannot do, he cannot give these Broncos the confidence. And once they get the confidence, they smell blood in the water. They definitely going to go. With the athleticism and the speed, they can put pressure on Ogden right now. So let's see what Sammy, let's see how he built right now. Oh, can we get two?
There's one.
That's the score. That's why you hustled down the line.
It's a pretty good transfer, though.
It was. That's why you hustled down the line, ladies and gentlemen. Parents at home, tell your kids, man. Got a bunch of talent down the line. No. Coach E and Coach Troy, you guys can attest to. College coaches love seeing kids hustle on and off the field. Is that correct, gentlemen?
It's true.
More than 1,000% correct.
Yeah, my 1 year coaching college alone, like that was whenever we went to recruit somebody. Shout out to David Gomez, who was my recruiting coordinator. He was he always talked about, I want guys that play hard, I want guys that's grimy, I want guys that, that can really get after me. So.
Okay. Pitch. There we go. That might get down. Let's see. Get do it.
No, that's a great play by the right fielder.
Yes, it is.
That is a great play by the right fielder. The ball slicing back in. That was a hard hit ball by Jonathan Patterson.
It was. Hey, speaking of the guru, you know about that, though.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Jonathan Patterson, he might be the most.
Good baseball.
Absolutely.
He's been playing some good baseball this year.
Patterson with a hard hit ball. He's been tearing up for Kenwood. I got to give him his props.
He made a play last week against Simeon going off into foul territory. Diving play into the con. And in my mind, I was just like, those are the guys that college coaches want. You know, they want guys that's gonna go hard. They want guys that's gonna lay it all on the line.
Sammy comes set in the pitch. Here we go.
That is a good play by the second baseman. Okay, Ogden.
So, as we go to the top of the third, Ogden one, Kenwood one. Right back. We back, ladies and gentlemen. Kavari back on the bump. We got Troy. We lucky to have Troy for a couple more innings, and he got to go transform the coach. Kavari, that's what I've had. So, Troy, let's talk about the program this year for Ace, man. How you guys looking, man, from top to bottom, man? You know who's the next guys this kid's looking at? And, I mean, schools are looking at, you know.
Yeah, no, we.
Oh, that's opposite field hit.
Johnny Patterson in left field is, he's good, man. He's just a gamer. He's one of those kids that you can put anywhere. He's what I like to call a glue guy.
A glue guy.
He's a glue guy. He keeps the team together. You can plug him in the infield, in the outfield. You can put him anywhere. Ben Zobrist. Remember Ben Zobrist?
Yeah.
He reminds me of Ben Zobrist, man. Dude can play everywhere but catch and pitch. He can pitch too, though. But yeah, no, man, we got a pretty good up and coming group right now. I say our 2027 group, our freshmen, those guys are tough. From the Blake Ragsdales to the Mikey Watsons, mm-hmm. Braden Parks, Ahmad Dunbars, like those kids can play, man. And they're all playing for the high school right now, which is important.
Who coaches that team?
That's going to be Coach Smoke.
Shout out to Coach Smoke, my boy.
Coach Smoke, Coach Marcus Rogers, man.
Well, we need to get Marcus Rogers. We need to get Coach Marcus up here, too, for an interview, man.
Yeah, that's their group. And I think they're going to be—they're going to some of the top tournaments in the country to see this the summer. So
speaking of that, is that one thing that Ace wanted to do is, you know, make a bigger splash in tournaments like that? Is that something that you guys talked about?
Yeah, I mean, so myself along with the team, like we're trying to be very intentional about making sure that we are putting our kids on the biggest platform possible.
Oh, Davin Play, and he is through. With a host down the line, an infield hit.
Good effort by DeMario.
Man, great effort by DeMario.
Yeah, so we were just trying to be super conscious about, like, putting our kids on the highest platform that we could.
Okay.
You know, like, unfortunately, sometimes what happens is, you know, people want to go to the top level tournaments, and, you know, for us, it's always making sure that we go and we're prepared.
Right.
You know, I don't want to go just to say we went.
Yeah, and that's a lot of people say, oh, we're going out of town. You go out of town 40,000 times and rank up all that, and you're not even ready to play.
That's never been my thing, to just go just to say we win. So my big thing is making sure that we go down there, and, you know, we're going to Hoover, Alabama, to the PG tournament down there.
That's huge.
PG Invitational. You know, we want to make sure we go down there and compete. Mm-hmm. You know, this group is full of talent, so I think we have what it takes. We just got to go down there and put it all together.
I believe so, man. One thing I know about you, Troy, shout out to Anthony, man. Shout out to my boy. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if he's in the building or not. But, you know, shout out to him, too. And I think I seen Kevin Cole here, too, if I'm not mistaken. Was Kevin Cole here?
Kev Cole is in the building,
Kevin
man.
Kevin Cole.
Cincinnati Reds.
We need to get him in here for an interview,
director
too, man.
Director of youth baseball, man. He's doing his thing. Kev hired me.
There we go. Oh, good throw.
Oh. Yeah, Kev hired me, man. 10 years ago with Ace.
Man, that's crazy.
He hired me as a coach. I came back home. I was leaving Atlanta. I was coming home looking for work, and I knew I wanted to coach. And Kevin gave me my first crack at it. So
that's what's up, man.
I'm forever grateful for him. And him and I talk off. I look at him as a mentor, and, you know, just an overall good guy.
On a swing. One ball, two strikes, one batter. The ticket, as they call him, stares in, gets the call. Shakes it, he wants it, looks, he sets, ready to deliver.
The pitch.
Low.
It's a good pitch, man. I like when he shows the changeup early. I think that, you know, you have the ability to show that you can throw your off speed at any count. It makes hitters question what they're doing.
That 2-2 count?
As a pitching guy, I love to see it. I love to see it.
So, Troy, one thing about also that Ace is doing, man, you guys have partnered and helped out. You guys have partnered and helped out a program that I'm a part of, man. General manager. Teflon softball, man. Talk to us about that. And we got a base hit? Nope. Swallow. Here we go.
Nah, man, dude, I'm so excited about the potential of what Teflon could be. You know, it's a black-owned program. I thought our game was marginalized, and I thought our game was gatekept by, you know, non-blacks. But the game of softball is even more segregated than our game. So,
yeah, man, it's tough.
Yeah, and I know you live it every day with your daughter. She's over at Andrew, and, you know, for the White Sox to come in and say, hey, look, we want to invest in this program. We want to make sure we put resources behind the girls as well. Like, as a father, that's you know, take my White Sox hat off. As a father, that's exciting for me. Because that's something that I would like for my daughter to be a part of.
They sit in the gap.
There we go.
Ogden's coming out. They showing that they are not scared of the ticket.
We got 2-1 ball game.
I mean, That's huge. You know, shout out to Coach India Stewart. She was the CEO and founder, man. She had a vision, and that was to give black and brown girls the equal opportunity to play at these huge tournaments, man. People don't know that. These softball teams be costing $35,000 to $4,000. Pickoff, did he get them? Save. Did he call them $3,000 to $4,000 to $5,000 at times, man? And, you know, it's priced out, but,
yeah.
You know, with the help of the Sox, man, we're able to, and India's vision.
Yeah, it's a game. It's just like baseball, the game, we've been priced out, you know, in the softball game as well. So for us, it was a no-brainer. You know, when Teflon's name came up in the room of the decision makers, for us it was like, why wouldn't we do this, you know? And so I'm excited. Anthony Olivo is probably the biggest softball cheerleader there is. He's the director of our program, man. I remember last year at the RBI regional, I came to the dugout. This dude had glitter
on his face.
Had glitter all up his arm. I'm like,
the girls made us do it.
I'm like, we're really doing this.
Yeah, so, the girls made us do it, man.
So nah, and the girls are exciting, man. It's an exciting game, and like I said, this is a program that I hope and wish will be around for a long time. You know, when we first started back in 2007, I was a part of that first group. It's tough. You're gonna take your bumps and lumps along the way, but to have a big league club supporting you in year two is
huge.
It's pretty. It's pretty cool. So
you got 3-1 count.
3-1. Sammy Castillo up.
And one thing about India, man, she has a mindset, and when she wants something, she's determined. You've been in those rooms. What do you hear her talk? She fights tooth and nail for everything for these girls. And you know, I'm happy to be a part of it. I'm glad that she allowed me to, you know, be a part of it and gave my daughter a chance to play at these levels. So,
yeah,
like you said about the diversity, my daughter is the only African American girl on the team in the whole program at Andrew.
Yeah, that's tough.
It's tough.
It's tough, but it's also
it's a blessing.
You know, it's a blessing, and she got to embrace it.
Yep, full count on a swing. Kavari about to get home. Kavari's showing a little rattling right now, man. That was a strikeout, but Sammy hustled down the line, didn't lose his composure, swung, seen it, and heard the ball get kicked back. And we have Carnell Blackman come out here and talk to the guys, man. What are you going to say to Kavari right now, Troy?
So, in this situation, rightfully so, it's frustrating. You know, as a pitcher, you get a strikeout and don't get out anytime you do that. That's frustrating, you know. So for me, if I'm Carnell, and I know Carnell very well, grew up with the guy, like, he's going out there to just calm the nerves. He's going to tell everybody, relax, look, we good. You know, we're good. We're gonna keep on competing, but we got to be better.
Right.
From a pitcher standpoint, we got to get ahead. From a catcher standpoint, we got to block the ball and keep it in front. So I think for Carnell, he's just going out saying, hey, look, let's relax. Chill out.
Okay. Yep. Stanton taking his walk back to the mound. We got two outs. Man on first and third. This is a big out right here.
So you gotta expect the guy first to get in motion here. You rather have two guys. I'm surprised they didn't pull Sammy off of the bases, you know.
Right. Yep. Yeah. So that's what's up, man. We trying to get the attention of Kevin Cole. Hopefully we can get him up here for an interview in between innings as well. You know. This is a tough situation right here. First and third, two outs. Kavari got to settle down. Kenwood got a hit, man. He got a hit. You talked about that in the pregame.
Dude, timely hitting, man. If you don't get timely hitting, you can't win baseball games. So if you got runners in scoring position, Sammy Castillo has no lead at first base.
None.
Like, none at all.
If he going, would you pinch run for him right now?
And Absolutely.
I mean, why wouldn't you? You can do it for the catches.
Just start the catches. It's just starting pitching, man. He should be off the bases.
That's just me thinking.
That might be a coaching blunder by the.
I don't know why he's right there. He has no lead. Kavari ain't gotta. Don't even take attention to him. On the swing. If Kavari can get out this inning, this would be huge for the Broncos, man. One ball, one strike, two outs. Run on first and third. Kavari looks in. Come set to deliver.
Good pitch. It's a good pitch by Thunderbird.
There it is. Here we go. We got Ogden 2, Kenwood 1. As we go to the bottom of the third. And we'll be right back.